Hey everyone, in this video I'll be going over all-wheel drive. Now once again, all-wheel drive, there's a lot of different companies will give it a different definition. So for the purposes of my video, I'm going to have two types, one being regular all-wheel drive, just the standard definition, and the other being automatic all-wheel drive. So the difference between all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive. So all-wheel drive is just like full-time four-wheel drive, if you watch my other video on four-wheel drive, except there's no selection between high and low gear. Now the difference between automatic all-wheel drive and regular all-wheel drive is that automatic all-wheel drive typically will only drive two wheels, either the front or the back, and then when those lose traction, it will send power to the other wheels. And that will be electronically done. It won't be something that the driver does. It's going to be something that the ECU will control. So I'm going to go over that a little bit. So this is one setup, and once again, there are many different types of all-wheel drive setups. I'm just going to use this example just to show one scenario of how it can be done. So you've got your engine here in the front of the car, and that's made to a transmission. So the transmission is going to have a gear that's connected to a gear on the front drive shaft. So once again, this is the front of the car. So as this front drive shaft rotates, it's got a bevel gear that is connected to the drive shaft that will go toward the rear tires. So it will rotate both these front tires and this shaft. Now I've put three different devices on this shaft. All three are not going to be on the shaft. I just wanted to show several different devices that can be used in all-wheel drive. So it could be just a differential. It actually could be a differential and a viscous coupling, but you wouldn't see those with a multi-plate clutch. This I'm pretty much going to use for explaining the automatic all-wheel drive. So a differential, if you don't know how that works, I've attached a video in the link. A link in the video description that does a great job of explaining that. Also, but basically what a differential allows to happen is the front tires can rotate at a different speed than the rear tires. And this is so that when you go around a corner, as I've described in my Ackerman Principle video, as you go around a corner, the front tires move more quickly than the rear tires because the radius is larger. So this will allow that to happen without any buckling or understeer or tire wear to occur. Okay, so a viscous coupling, that's another option. The great thing about a viscous coupling is if a set of tires starts to spin with an open differential, it'll just keep spinning and you'll pretty much just be immobilized. Whereas with a viscous coupling, torque is transferred to the tires that are not spinning. So how this works is inside this viscous coupling, here's one shaft coming in here, and then this is all the other shaft. So there's a series of discs inside this, and then there's an outer casing that has like a reverse disc. It's almost like a multi-plate clutch pack, but a little different because it's just a series of discs, and then there's a thick fluid inside. So say the blue and green rotate separately. So say the blue is rotating much more quickly than the green, because your front tires are spinning, well, that's going to cause the green to catch up because of the thick fluid inside. The friction will cause the torque to transfer to these rear tires. So if the front tires do start to spin, your car will just automatically start sending more torque to the rear tires. So that's a good mechanical option for solving that problem. All right, now let's talk about automatic all-wheel drive. So automatic all-wheel drive, once again, this can be found in something like the Honda CR-V, where it'll be front-wheel drive unless you lose traction, and then it will send traction to the rear tires. So let's look at how that would happen. So let's ignore that this viscous coupling and say that doesn't exist, and we could take that out or we can leave it, no big deal. So we'll have that in there. Okay, so let's just say that's gone and we've got this multi-plate clutch. So your front tires start to spin. Now you've got sensors for things like traction control, stability control, and ABS. You've got sensors in all your tires that are measuring how fast they're going. So when your computer sees that these tires are spinning, it engages this clutch. Now, I'm not going to go over how multi-plate clutch works. I have a video on that, so if you are curious, I'll attach the link to that video in the video description for this video. And so it'll engage this multi-plate clutch, which means it will connect this shaft here to this shaft here. And this shaft here will already be rotating, and then when it engages this clutch, it will engage the rear tires. So a computer will activate that, and once you regain traction and it sees that all four tires are once again spinning at the same speed, it will disengage this clutch pack, and then it will just be powering the front tires again. Okay, and the difference, you may be looking at these and thinking, well, are these the same thing? Well, no, they're not. The difference is, this is compressible here. These can squeeze. These red plates here can squeeze together. That's how a clutch works. And these here are just a series of discs that are alternating which shaft they're connected to, and then they cause each other to spin. So that's the basic idea of how all-wheel drive works. Now, once again, different companies do it in different manners. This is just the manner I chose to describe it so that it was fairly simple to understand.